ounce of clean.
Yeah. 1 ounce of neutralizer.
One ounce
tired,
of neutralizer.
Not that yeah. tired.
You let me know when I have 1 ounce in there for Sammy.
Right there.
Right there. So I have a total of 5 ounces.
That's also a tile fraction.
You can use it, you can use clean. You can use it to do all kinds of things. You can even use it to boost your salsa. No, you can use it for a lot of different things.
I think that could work good for laundry and stuff too.
It works great for laundry.
Yeah.
I mean, it works excellent for laundry.
Yeah, it seems like it would be the right product for that.
Our customers yeah. clean their mops and their bonnets with it.
Okay? Now that would be a miracle.
Now, if you have equal parts of clean, neutralizer, and water, you will have the best, most effective, most expensive grout cleaner money can buy. But it cleans the grout very well. However, we do have a grout cleaner, okay? That is not as expensive as going this way.
Just out of curiosity, and I know you can't like be nailed down on it, but what are we talking about here on one of those gallons? What are one of those little babies going to run?
$160.
Okay.
I like this guy. full retail, commercial price is $30. And neutralizer is $19.
Okay.
Well, it's very comparable to, in fact.
Everything we buy is $30.
When I did the market research, we had a little bit less. And if you buy it, like somebody I know that is here in the room, but he told me, no, don't ever say my name because then, you know, the secret will be out. If you buy it, then 55-gallon drums becomes cheaper. We have it in gallons, and fives, and 55s, and even totes.
You like? So now the thing is with the electrolyte, it keeps making, it basically just breaks the surface tension off of it and allows stuff just to keep coming out.
It neutralizes the surface.
It neutralizes it, but what I'm wondering is you got a deep stain or like a spill, like you said, coffee spill, you know, Fremont peas on the carpet, and it's down in the backing, and I mean, you're going to be going over it quick with your pad or something.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What about wick back later?
It
this
will not
is
wick
back here, so it's not going to get
fresh coffee.
I have not have a situation reported by a customer or by using the product that they have the weakening effect.
Okay.
Or the ghosting effect. However, it's possible.
I would say the same thing if I was you.
But, you know, I will try it, and if you have problems, let us know because we want to know. So now I'm gonna go ahead and spray it, and then I'm gonna go ahead and use the padding to do it first with the padding. And I have a couple pieces of equipment, just so you see, that can be used with different types of equipment.
Is that just a typical buff? Just a bucket pad.
It's a white nylon pad.
Right.
So I just got this sprayer. And I love it because it's my size. You know what I mean? I don't have to go all the way down.
Yeah.
And it's very effective. It's like 45 PSI. And you notice that I keep leaving the gum in there because I want to give it dwell time. It has to be on the safe side. And what I'm going to do, guys, I'm going to go ahead and do the worst half with the bonneting. Actually, I'm going to do the whole thing with the bonneting, and then we go with the extractor over. Yes, so you see that it can be done, okay? Even if I was going to be using the self-contained extractor or a truck mount or a counter brush machine, I will be pre-spraying the cup. Okay, because it works better. You can inject the chemical better onto the carpet. Thank you. That's one of the functions of John, to remind me when I do something wrong. you just spray the pad so you have a little bit a better gliding effect. Do you remember how to do it?
I'm doing that.
You know, the first, no, it's fine. The first time that that I saw John using a floor machine, it looked kind of different, you know what I mean? Maybe because he's Chinese or something, you know? But I think
it's racist. You know? I'm not even Chinese.
And if I can remember which button to push.
It works better when you plug it in.
It's plugged in. It's better if you don't interrupt me.
Okay.
You gotta pull the handle at the same time.
No, but you see on the Mercury, there's a little trick here. Of course, you know, I'm not gonna clean the gum with the floor machine. And I just go about three passes. Doesn't really give me a lot of room to overlap here, but let me see if I can go around over here. Thank you, Scotty. For larger areas, I will be using a 20-inch machine, although I find the 17 to be more effective when you're doing carpets. If you have a carpet with a deep pile, use a brush. And the Tampico brush works very, very well, I mean extremely well in this process.
So you pre-spray and just use a brush like you're using now?
Yes, yes. So that's basically it. Let me see if we got as dirty as we would like to. If not, then I'm gonna have to clean some of the hotel's carpet. Oh, yeah. Okay. So the reason that we use the bonnet.
Don't blink.
Is for this reason, okay? I can literally continue using it, and I have used it sometimes when I'm cleaning carpets with a customer or so, where it gets the soil gets up to here. When I take it, it's dark all the way. You see how it begins to go up? It takes a while to get it dirty, okay? But it will get dirty. That's how electrolytic releases soil.
That's neutral again.
It's water.
Oh, just plain water.
Yeah.
Okay. So be careful, you got it on your hands. You know what's happening to people in LA with that water.
Yeah, but I had neutralizer right here too. Yeah.
It's already neutral.
And this rinses very quickly, and also it's not gonna dry, but you can reuse it very fast. Okay.
Yeah, if you're outside close to shaking
out. Yeah. Usually what my customers have, they don't have this little square thing. They have a bucket. Yes, like you will when you have bonnets. And I think your guys use a lot of pads, right?
Yeah.
And they just go ahead and rinse them all.
They
both.
They use one pad at a time.
Yeah.
Yeah, one of
them. Ready to go.
Yeah.
And one of those window buckets, you use the window cleaners?
I use a window bucket, yeah.
Yeah. They're nice size.
I usually have a window bucket.
The issue with when this water gets really soiled, it still will just drop it along.
Yes, because as we are cleaning the carpet, you're leaving the water in the bucket and it's settling down. It's going down. And if you leave it long enough, what was it when we did it at your place? Like an hour or so?
Yeah,
That the water is clean.
On the
because everything goes down to the bottom. In fact, when we emptied the bucket, we had a lot of dirt on the bottom. Lots of dirt that you didn't say, wow. And we vacuumed and extracted and everything. So that's how we do this. Now, if you do it with the bonnet, you will get the same effect, except that the bonnet doesn't clean as well. Okay?
Oh, doesn't clean as well?
No, it cleans, but because, you know, you, most bonnets are a mix.
Yeah.
You know, cotton, nylon.
Yeah, it doesn't work as good.
Yeah, it doesn't work as good, yeah.
I have poly cotton.
Yeah, yeah. And this works a lot better. I mean, you know, I like it.